All right, this is John Cola with Growing Your Greens and the garden update for today. So you can see we got some major progress done. We've been the plants have been growing all themselves, and it's almost grown up the arbor here. And you can see we did something. We finally got the edging on the beds, on the front bed anyways. So this is how it looks with the edging on. It looks a nice finished look. And the thing I did want to point out is for snail protection and slug protection, got here, I'm sitting on the ground now, and you can see at the top of the little posts right here, this is some trim work we put on, and at the top here we have basically copper to repel the slugs and snails. And then actually underneath the top cap, you can see, you know, this is the top cap here, and then if you look from underneath, there's a good shot of underneath. This is also copper, so we use copper roof flashing. And we cut it down into strips. So now if, you know, the thing is, if snails or slugs come up and they crawl up this, which is oiled cedar, which I actually haven't seen too many crawl up on yet. They get up to here and then they get shocked when they try to, you know, crawl over this copper. And then hopefully the goal is they go back the other direction. And we have this all the way around all the bed, so that hopefully come wintertime, when it does get really wet and moist out here, because right now it's summertime. Or, well, fall. And, you know, hopefully we will not have a snail challenge as we have had in previous years. So the tops are definitely a nice thing. Sage has been working hard. He's actually out today working on it. Here's the saw we have. We've been using to cut all the miter cuts. And so remember, this is how it looks with the top on. And remember, this is how it looked with it off. And this is still unfinished. So this is going to get worked on next. Looks a lot nicer with the, you know, just nice and finished, you know, with the top on there. One of the problems that we didn't arise or didn't know that we were gonna have actually is in the front, actually these front two beds that are actually really tall, they're approaching, you know, 3 feet high. We've been having a problem with the soil pushing too much weight on the 4x4 posts. So maybe back here you can see the construction. Basically back over here we have the 4x4 post sunk in. You can see the previous videos on this, and when the soil level is too high, actually what happened is the soil just literally pushes out on the posts. And we thought we dug the post in, we sank the post about 2 feet deep in concrete, and it was still pushing them out. So Sage is here hard at work repairing the push outs. And how we're doing that is we're using these nylon straps to strap to it, and with a ratchet, and then we ratchet it shut. And then what we're doing is below soil level, we're actually just putting some fence board, some wood, actually, to tie the two together so that they will not no longer, you know, want to bulge out. And so that was the easiest solution. We were thinking about using stainless steel chain and some hooks, or then we were thinking about using some copper pipe and just soldering it into place. But then I guess the cheapest and easiest, and we could replace it later when it rots, because this is going to be buried, but we did oil the cedar wood. We'll just replace it when it rots, and hopefully by then maybe it won't want to lean. We're also putting the tops on, and the top does give it a little bit more structural stability as well. So that was the update for today on the raised bed garden here, and we'll give you a tour on new things that have been planted recently. Want to say a couple words, Sage?
Howdy, folks. Just out here in the heat. I think it's what? In the 90s today. 90 what? 5, 96, something like that. So we got the umbrella out.
Yeah, get your handy patio umbrella. We have it on a stand, and so Sage uses that many times for shade protection from the sun and also in the wintertime from the rain.
Right, I throw a tarp over it, yeah.
And in a pinch too, you could use that to you know, shade out some of your plants if they're getting too hot.
You sure could, but I would probably steal it from them if I got hot.
All right, thanks, Sage.